This is my first. So hey guys, what's up? It's me, Clara. This is my first video ever on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate it. Hey guys, it's me, Clara, and this is my first video up on YouTube. So yeah, and hey guys, what's up? It's me, Clara, and this is my first video up on YouTube. So I'm pretty excited to get started into this. I can't speak today. Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Clara, and I am so excited to get started into this video today because this is my first video up on YouTube, and I'm actually really excited to be filming it and editing it and then eventually putting it on YouTube. So if you're watching, thank you so much. So we're just gonna hop right into this video and get started because, you know, why not? I don't like long intros. Alright, so as you can probably tell from the title of this video is... excuse me. This video is a video So as you can probably tell from the title of this video is about 5 times that I thought someone was breaking into my house. Actually 4 of the times I thought, or breaking into my house, or like someone was like in my house, like that shouldn't be there, you know. You know what I'm talking about? Okay. So anyway, 4 of the times actually it was my experience, and 1 other time it was my brother's experience, and kind of my experience, but not really my experience. So let's get right into the video. Alright, so these are actually pretty funny stories. So the first time takes place back at my old house, and what had happened was I was in 5th grade and I was coming home from school. I used to live really close to my school, and so I would walk home, and my house is like 2 blocks away from the school. So I was coming home from school, and I was walking home, and no one was at my house yet, so it was just me, like, walking home, like, alone. And I, being the dumb 5th grader that I was, forgot my key to my house. But luckily, we did have a spare in the back. It was, like, one of those things where, like, open it up, and then there's, like, a code that you punch in or whatever, and then, like, the key comes out. Okay, well, we had one of those, and I was like, you know what, I'll just go back there and use that. So, yeah. So, I mean, like, my mom always told me to carry my key, but, you know, I was, like, this dumb 5th grader, and, like, you know, I didn't carry my key. So, what had happened was, I opened the thing, and I got my key out, right? And so, I was, like, going to the back door, and, you know, like, I don't know if you guys do this, but, like, I do this all the time. Like, even if I know the door is going to be locked, like, I, like, push it, like, just to make sure, like, just to make sure you don't have to take that extra step of putting the key in, like, just in case, like, the door was unlocked. And usually, like the door is never unlocked, but the door was unlocked. And so I was like, why is the door unlocked? So this is really weird because, like, my parents are, like, it was probably my dad was the last person to leave, but my parents are, like, super, like, I cannot speak today. I'm sorry for how many times I say like in this video. And, I'm probably gonna say a lot, too. Okay, so, my parents are super on top of locking the doors when they leave. Like, we have an alarm in our new house, so, like, setting the alarm, like, all those things, you know. But, in this old house, we didn't have an alarm or anything. I go to reach for the door to, like, see if it opens, and it opens. And I was like, why is this door open? Like, I started, like, getting, like, this is weird, like, my doors are never open, and so I go, hello, and no one answered. Actually, I don't know if I went hello, but no one was in the house. Like, all the cars were gone, and no one was in the house, okay? I can tell you, no one was in the house. Like, no noise, nothing. Like, it was pretty creepy. So I was like, this is weird, but anyway, you know, I just, like, sat down, watched TV, made myself a snack, you know, whatever, and then I was sitting there, and then the phone rang, and it's my uncle on the phone, right? And so I pick up, and I'm like, hey, like, what's up? Like, how's it going? And I don't know if you guys have a home phone, but if you do, you know that if someone is on the other line, you can hear it. It sounds different. Like, it kind of sounds like you're hearing their breathing, but you're not actually hearing their breathing, but you can definitely tell if someone is on the other line. And the only other phone was in my parents' bedroom. And so I was like, hey, and I was, like, talking to my uncle, and then I started hearing, like, someone was on the other line, and I was, like, this is so creepy. The door was unlocked, and now, like, it sounds like someone's on the other line. Like, I don't know. So I, like, talked to my uncle for, like, very quickly, and I was, like, I gotta go. Like, he lives in Austin, so it's not like I could have, like, told him, like, hey, like, I think someone might be listening. Plus, they're listening. Like, you can't just say that. They're listening to the phone, you know? So I hung up the phone, and I was in fifth grade, guys. I was not gonna about to go explore, and I was this fifth grade little girl. I was not about to go and explore and see, like, is someone listening to the phone, or is it just me? Yeah. So I, hung up the phone, grabbed my little flip phone that I had, and I ran out, and I hid. We had, like, a kind of alleyway that leads out next to our garage, and I hid behind the trash cans. And I was so scared. And then, like, my brother came home, and I, like, made him check under the bed or whatever. And, like, I never found anything, but, like, it, like, psyched me out so badly, guys. You don't even know, like, the door was unlocked, and then, like, I heard, like, someone on the other end of the phone, and I never knew what happened. And there was a door they could have left from, through my parents' old bedroom, so, yeah. I don't know. I never knew what happened to that one. Alright, so that was my first story. As I said, this is, like, a bunch of different stories. So my second story, okay, so, flash forward, 2 years later, like, less than 2 years later, and, we just got this new house, and, my brother was, like, it's his first time being home alone, and let me tell you, like, we moved from, like, a really nice neighborhood, to kind of, like, it's, like, a mixed-income neighborhood, so it's not, like, bad, but, you know, like, it's very different, like, there's a lot of people just, like, walking around and whatever, so it was my brother's first time being home alone. This is his story, by the way, guys, but, like, you know, I'm in it, so I'm gonna tell y'all. So it was his first time being, like, home alone, and, you know, like, you could get, like, kind of scared, like, just freaked out, like, any little noise scares you, right? Okay, so, this is funny. Okay, so, me and my mom were out, we went to Target, we just, like, you know, like, go to Target, like, get some groceries. I think we went to, like, go to Kohl's to go, I don't know, but anyway, we were out, and my brother, I got some text messages, guys. Anyway, so my brother calls my mom, and I'm with my mom, so, like, this is part of why I come in. And he's like, hey, so, I think I just heard some, like, footsteps downstairs, and, like, I don't know, like, and my mom's like, okay, get out of the house, because, like, you know, like, you want to get out of the house, you don't want to stay in the house. And my mom's like, oh, no, like, she thinks my brother is probably, like, you know, like, just, like, thinking he's hearing things, but he, you know, so she's like, get out of the house, and my brother's like, yeah, I'm just, like, standing outside the house. And so she was like, okay, so my mom was like, I'm gonna call the police, and, like, just in case, you know, like, you don't want to, like, mess around with those things. So my mom ended up calling the police. They came and they checked it out, and, like, nothing was there. So me and my mom got home, the police were checking it out, and they were like, we don't see anything, like, there's no one in the house, like, they went and checked the whole house. So a few months later, my brother admits to us, he's like, hey, you remember that time that, like, I thought, like, I heard footprints in the house? He was like, well, I figured out it was just, like, the ice maker, like, making noise, because he was upstairs, and we were like, what? He was like, yeah, and we were like, oh my god. So it was just the ice maker the whole time, guys. Don't freak out on me. No, but, yeah, so, yeah. And, that's kind of the end of that story. I just thought that was kind of funny because, you know, like, he thought it was, like, something huge and it was, like, just the ice maker, because in our old house, we didn't have an ice maker, yeah. And, you know, but, I can see how you could think that, because, like, when our ice maker is making noise, it kind of sounds like someone's moving around, so, yeah. Okay, this third story is super, super, super funny, and, like, this is, like, my favorite one of all of them, but it's, like, freaky at the same time. It's, like, weird. So, it was spring break, and it was, like, snowing so much, like, it was weird. It was snowing a bunch in spring break, and, but my mom and my dad had to go to work, so they went to work, but we had, like, days off. It might have been before. I'm not exactly sure when it was, but we had snow days, and I think it was spring break. And, it was me and my three other, siblings that were home, and, my brother was upstairs, and my other brother and my stepsister and stepbrother and I were downstairs, and we were, just watching TV. And then, like, suddenly, like, I'm like, oh, I'm gonna go get some food. So I stand up, and, like, here's the living room, like, here's the kitchen back here. But then there's, like, a straight, like, we have a shotgun house. I don't know if you know what that is, but it's, like, if you point a shotgun from, like, the front of the house and, like, shoot a bullet, it'll go all the way through the back of the house. I hope that's not too much information for you guys. Anyway, so we have one of those houses. So I get up and I'm like going to walk. I'm going to walk to the kitchen, which is right here. But like I can see the front door from here. I can see the back door. So out of the corner of my eye, I see someone in the front door, and they're like all black. Like they have this black ski mask on and all black, and they're looking through the windows. And at this time, like at this period of time, like there were no cars home, you know, because no one in my family was driving at this point. So there were no cars, so it was only my mom and my dad's car, and they were both gone because they were at work. And so this person was looking through the window, and I saw them out of the corner of my eye, and I like, jolted back, like, so like they couldn't see me. And I was like, guys, stop the TV. So like they paused the TV, and I was like, there's someone like looking in our windows. And they're like, shut up, like stop lying to me. And I was like, I swear there's someone looking in our windows. And they're like, you're like lying. And I was like, I'm not, look out the window. And so I was like, Harrison, who's my brother, I was like, look out the window. And he's like, okay. So he peeks over so we can see the front door, like out of his cabinet thing, and he like peeks and he's like, oh my god, there's someone looking out the front door. And we're like, oh my god. And we were like all so scared. My sister like checked and she was like, yeah. And so we were scared because this person was like just looking through the windows and just like standing there and like in this all black ski mask. So we were sitting and we're like, oh, what should we do? And I like jumped behind my couch so that if I needed to, like if they broke in, like I could just like run out the back door and like jump the fence or something. So we're like, oh god. So then we're all like there, we're like scared, we're like, what should we do? Like Ben's upstairs, like what should we do? And so we're like thinking about what we should do, and then my brother comes downstairs and we're like all like, what's gonna happen? Okay. And so he walks down the stairs and he opens the door and we're like, why did he just open the door? And then he goes, oh hey Jeremiah. So he walks down the stairs and he opens the door and he goes, oh hey, and I'm just gonna like change this person's name. Called Alex. We go, oh hey Alex, and we're like, what? And he's like, oh, and he's like, bye, and we're like, wait, Ben, what? And he's like, and we like all walk out, and sure enough, this is his, like his friend was standing at the door like waiting for him because they were gonna like go do something at his house. He lives like a couple streets down, and he like, who? What? So we were just there and we were like, what? Like, what the heck? And so he came back in the house, like, because we were like, Ben, like, what? And he was like, and we like, at that point, we were walking in the front door, like, all of us, and he was like, oh, Alex and I are gonna go to his house and, like, do something. And we were like, okay. And so what we figured out later was that his friend Alex looking through the window, and because it was snowing outside, like we couldn't put two together at the time, but because it was snowing outside, he had like this black ski mask on, he was like heavy boots, like all black, and he was like waiting for Ben. But like still, like who just looks through your windows like while waiting for a friend, like knock on the door, I don't know, something like. But afterwards, I was, like, laughing. I was, like, we were so scared because we thought someone was, like, trying to break into our house. And, like, turns out, like, it was just someone looking through our windows. Yeah, but, I thought that was pretty funny. Okay, this next story, is... Okay, I have two stories left, guys. Ready? Alright, so this one was, it happened during the summer. And I was home alone, and I heard these short burp. 1 minute. Hanging out on my phone, and I was home alone because it was summer and my whole family was gone. Why do these always happen when I'm home alone? No, but I heard this noise downstairs, and it sounded like this, like it sounded like, and they happened randomly, but like imagine that sound like in twos, but like on wood, like, and like I was upstairs, so I like heard it and I was like, whatever, like the floor is creaking, and I heard it again. I heard it so many times. And I heard it, like, randomly, and it wouldn't happen, like, evenly, and so I was, like, getting scared. So for some reason, I don't know why, I ran up the stairs, I did not run up the stairs. I was already upstairs. I'm sorry. So I ran into my parents' room, and for some reason I got like a jar. Like, I don't know what a jar would have done to protect me, but I got a jar that, it wasn't even like a jar. It was kind of like a vase, like a thing, and I like grabbed it, like, so I could like go down to, I don't even know, like, was, I don't know what I was planning to do, like smashing it on their head. I'm not sure, but I got the jar, and I like creeped downstairs slowly, and then I was like looking over my stair rail, and guys, I think we should honestly like start a foundation for like how dumb I am, like a charity, like get Clara some common sense, please. It was the Roomba, like, going over the carpets. If you don't know what a Roomba is, it is, like, a little electric vacuum thing, and it's, like, a circle, and you can, like, put it on your carpets, and it, like, vacuums your carpets for you. And, like, oh, my God. The noises that I heard were it going over the carpet, because, like, I was looking, and then suddenly I thought, like, the same noise, and I was like, guys, how many times... I kid you not, so many times I've thought, like, someone was in my house. I'm so dumb. Or someone was trying to get into my house. I'm dumb. Especially because the reason I cringe at this is we had an alarm system. So I would have heard a beep, beep, beep if, like, the door would have opened or something. Like, it wasn't, like, set, but, like, you can, like, if you have an alarm system, you know, like, you can still hear, like, when the door opens, you can hear, like, beep, 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 or, like, beep, beep, or, like, something, like, some sort of beeping, like, you know, But yeah, I know. Sorry, guys. Okay, this last story is also super, 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 super funny. Okay, so, once again, Clara was home alone. Guys, why am I home alone all the time? Like, I need to get some friends. I call them up. Like, I feel like I'm all... I need friends, guys. No, but I was home alone, and once again, home alone, and, I feel like, you know, like, the movie Home Alone, I feel like I should be in that movie, you know, because I'm always home alone. I'm not always home alone, but, you know, I was home alone in all these stories, except for the one with my brother. Okay, I think, I don't know. Okay, anyway, what happened was I was, you know, just, hanging out in my house, and was in my kitchen making myself a snack, because that's what I do most of the time, and someone rings the doorbell, and so I'm like, I hate answering the door if I'm home alone. Like, I don't do it because, like, I look like this self-defenseless girl. So, you know how, like, you, like, hear stories of criminals, like, ringing the doorbell, like, burglars to, like, see, like, is anyone home? And, like, if someone's home, can I, like, beat them and then, like, get all their stuff? Like, yeah, like, I hate ringing the doorbell because I always, like, hate ringing the doorbell. I hate answering the doorbell because I always think that's going to happen. So, like, and, you know, like, people always say, tell you, like, don't answer the door when you're home alone. Or, like, say, like, don't, or, like, ask who it is first. But my door is glass. Like, my door is glass, so I just don't answer the door, because it's, like, if it's glass, like, they can obviously, like, see you through the, they can obviously, like, see you and who you are through the glass, and, like, you know, so, like, they can't imagine you as some big guy, so I usually just don't answer the door. I know that sounds bad, because if it was a burglar and no one answered the door, they'd, like, be more inclined to come in, but anyway, in general, I just don't answer the door if I'm home alone, because I don't know who it's gonna be. So, they rang the doorbell, and I was like, I'm just not gonna answer it. And so, and also, like, I feel like anywhere I could, like, peer out through my kitchen, like, they would definitely be able to see me. So, like, I'm just gonna, like, wait here and, like, not look and, like, just stand in the corner until they go away. So they rang my doorbell, and no one answered for, like, 30 seconds. Because, of course, no one answered because I was the only one home, but I didn't answer. And then they rang the doorbell again, and I was like, who rings the doorbell twice? Because this had me freaked. Like, I was like, who rings the doorbell twice? Like, are you kidding me? Like, if, like, unless they need something or they're trying to rob your house, like, you ring the doorbell once, no one answers, you leave. But I was like, whatever, maybe some people ring it twice, like, maybe, like, I don't even know. Like, I was thinking the worst at this moment. So I was, like, still hiding in my kitchen. And then, like, so then, like, I peered out, and I'm pretty sure they saw me, like, pretty sure. And I peered out of my kitchen, and I'm pretty sure they saw me, and, it was definitely a man, like, it was not, like a little petite girl or something, like, it was a man, and then, like, I don't know if this is bad, but, like, whenever I see men, I'm always, like, more inclined to, like, not want to answer the door, like, I don't know if that's bad or not, but, you know, that's me. So, I was, like, I'm just gonna stand here, I don't care if you saw me, you can leave, you know, like, bye. And so I was standing there in my kitchen waiting for this person to leave. and they rang the doorbell again. And I was getting so scared at this moment. I was like, obviously they want me. Like, they're coming for me. Like, what the heck? Like, they're coming for me. So I was getting, by the way, guys, if I look like there, it's because there's like a window and it's dark outside. And yeah, I'm looking at my reflection. Okay. Anyway, so I was getting like pretty scared. I was like, who rings the doorbell 3 times? And I was like, I didn't know what to do. And then they rang the doorbell for a 4th time. Like, oh my God. At this moment, I like walked out and ran into the backyard. And I just stood there and I like texted my mom. And I was like, Mom, someone rang the doorbell 4 times. Like, you know, like I was a little bit. But I texted my mom. I was like, Mom, someone rang the doorbell 4 times, and I'm getting scared, and like they won't leave. And I was like, and my mom took like 4 or 5 minutes to text back, because you know, like she didn't see it immediately. Like, I'm sure if she saw it immediately, she would have texted back. But then she was like I'm pretty sure in like all caps. 1 second. I'm sorry, guys. And she, like, texted back in all caps. She was like, Clara, I ordered a rug. Like, I need you to go get it. She ordered a rug, guys. And, like, she was like, that is the delivery guy. She was like, it needs to be signed for. Like, you need to sign it or he's going to have to go take it back to the place and we're going to have to go pick it up. Or it's going to come and leave. Because this was our new house. Like, we were still moving in, so we were still getting new things. And she was like, I ordered a rug. Like, hurry up. Like, go get it. And I was like, oh, I'm so sorry. And, like, I ran, but the guy was gone. So, yeah. So, yeah. But, we ended up, one minute. But we ended up, like, I felt so bad after that. Because, like, we ended up having to, like, get it. And it took, like, weeks for it to come back. And I was, like, the delivery guy probably saw me. And he was probably, like, hello, like, I need someone to sign for this. Like, he was not trying to do anything to me. But, me, I always think the worst. Okay. So, thank you guys. Why am I thanking you? Okay. Well, those are all my stories for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video, then give it a like and subscribe, because I intend on making more videos. Also, I don't know what I was gonna do for my next video, or if I'm even, I can't speak English, or if I'm even going to do a next video, but I really want to. And if you guys tell me to make another video, then I probably will. So, let me know if you like this video. Don't let me know if you didn't like it. No, I'm just kidding. Yeah, so, those are my 5 stories about times I thought people were breaking into my house, and really turned out no one was ever breaking into my house. The first story where, like, I heard someone on the other line, like, I'm not sure, like, I never figured that one out. I don't even know if I told my parents about that. You know, like, when you're, like, this has ever happened to you guys, like, you're, like, something happens to you, like, this is gonna, don't mean like that. I mean, like, I don't know, but you just never end up telling people, because you're just like, I don't know, like, that's kind of scary, like, I don't want to tell people. So, like, some people might not know all these things, some people might know all of them, you never know. Even if you do know all of them, I hope you enjoy this video, and thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a great week, day, year, life. I don't know. Have a great life. Bye, guys. I don't want a lot for Christmas. Sorry. I want to play that song, you know? That could be my intro, man. Right? Since it's like Christmas time, who is ready? I am so ready for Christmas time. Like, who is ready for? Stop myself before I embarrass myself anymore, but thank you. Hey guys, so make sure that you follow all of the social media also that I tagged below, because it's gonna be legit, so yeah, follow it, not tag below, link below in the description. And thanks for watching and have a very Merry Christmas. Also, if you are as excited about Christmas as I am, then you should definitely like this video. I don't know if that was English, but...